Hello everyone, how are you all? Hope everyone is safe and sound. So today, let's try to discuss on a very interesting topic, that is regarding the Reliance Jio's IPO, possibly. Yeah. Since Mukesh Ambani has not yet announced the Reliance Jio IPO, but then let us understand why there is a possibility of Reliance Jio's IPO. Now, Reliance Jio IPO, basically, Mukesh Ambani, guys, this guy is a genius. Why? Because his core business lies in petroleum business. But long before, in 2010 to 12, he decided to enter into a technological company, that is into the telecommunication sector. But then few obstacles prevented him from opening his own telecommunication business. Why? Because telecommunication business, which was owned by his brother Anil Ambani, and since there was a non-competitive clause between Mukesh Ambani and Anil Ambani, he was not able to enter into the venture of Reliance Jio. Basically, if you are aware, Anil Ambani owns Reliance Communication, which has become bankrupt today, right? So after the non-competitive clause came to an end back in 2012-13, Mukesh Ambani finally decided to enter into this space of telecommunication. Now, Mukesh Ambani's Reliance Industries Limited is majorly focused on the petroleum business earlier, but not now, because he envisioned that the future is not petrol. And I have already discussed regarding a case study on e-vehicles in the class. Hence, you all are aware that petroleum business is no more sunrise of the industry. Hence, let us now discuss top 5 profitable companies in India. Number 1 is Reliance Industries Limited, with a profit of around 43,368 crore rupees. The highest profitable company in India right now is Reliance Industries Limited. Number 2 goes for TCS, 3 HDFC Bank, 4 HDFC Limited, and number 5 is your ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. How does Reliance Industry earn? What is the profit from where does it earn so much? Basically, it earns 33.3% from the petrochemical business, refine and marketing, that is Reliance Gas, Reliance Aviation, Reliance Petroleum Retail, it earns around 26.7%. From Jio, which just started before 3 years, right now is occupying around 24.2% of the profits. Yeah, 24.2% in a matter of 3 years is unbelievable. Organized Retail, that is Reliance, from Reliance Digital, Trends, Reliance Fresh, 10.4%. Others, if you're not aware, the Colors Tamil, Colors Channel is owned by Reliance. News 80 Network, Money Control app, which is one of the best apps for stock market details. And CNBC Awaaz, which is the best stock market news channel in India. That contributes to only 4.9%. And financial services like Jio Money, Jio Payment Banks, which are not that much popular as of now, but expecting a lot of growth in this sector as well, owns around 0.5%. Reliance Industries owns all of these brands. MTV, which is a very famous channel, again Forbes, Viacom, Book My Show, the movie ticket booking app, as you all are aware, are owned by Reliance Jio. Let us now see what are the various products which has been come from Reliance Jio. Basically, if you see across, there are variety of products entered into by Reliance Jio. Basically, recently it launched Reliance Jio Fiber, Jio Saavn, Jio Chat, Jio Switch, Jio Call, Jio Health, Jio Security, Jio News, etc. N number of products coming up from the umbrella of Reliance Jio. In March 2020, Reliance Industries owned the entire 100% of Reliance Jio. Basically, Reliance Jio is right now a private limited company owned entirely by the Reliance Industries Limited, which is the holding company of Jio. So it's a 100% wholly owned subsidiary of Reliance Industries Limited. Now, what is going to happen is, basically, in March 2020, Reliance Industries Limited realized that it has accumulated a debt of around 1.6 lakh crore. And it had made a decision to cover up or to repay all these debt before December 2020. And based on that decision is where the selling off of the shareholding in Reliance Jio started. Basically, if you remember, Reliance Jio started selling off its shareholding with the help of Facebook. We'll see that also. But then Reliance Jio has now come up with the possibility of IPO. IPO is nothing but initial public offering, where the company, for the first time when it gets listed, it will issue its shares with the help of this process called initial public offering. In March 2020, Reliance Jio ended, or I would say completed, 3 years of its financial reporting. Now, as per the regulatory guidelines, let's say SEBI tells that only if you are there, or only if you have reported three financial reportings, that is 3 years of financial reportings, after that only you can come up for listing. So before that, it is not possible for getting your company listed. Hence, when Reliance Jio completed 3 years in the month of March 2020, that is very recently, after that, it has now, you know, come up with a complete selling, or in fact, a very gradual selling of its shareholding. The first selling being with the help of Facebook. Guys, Facebook is a worldwide known brand, and it has invested around 43,574 crores, coming up to around 9.99%, that is 10% of shareholding has been sold to Facebook. Reliance sold its shareholding to Facebook of its Jio subsidiary. Now, Jio Facebook partnership is one of the largest partnership, because users of WhatsApp is around 400 million. That is around 40 crore people, not in the world, only in India. So only in India, WhatsApp is used by around 40 crore people. Facebook is used by around 33 crore people. Jio is used by around 38.8 crores. Can you imagine, in the past 3 years, Jio has been able to capture so much of market in the Indian telecommunication sector that the users has raised up to the number one telecom company in India right now, and number two in the world when it comes to the subscribers amount. 38.8 crore people. Number of people who are using smartphones in India is right now around 450 million. So smartphone is different from the normal phone. 45 crore people are having this access to the, you know, smartphone. Number of internet users are around 60 crore. Basically, millions and a crore, like if I'm converting, it is coming to around 60 crore people are having access to internet. The second major investment came from this company, US-based Silver Lake. In fact, a very popular private equity investor, Silver Lake, has invested around 5,665 crores in Reliance Jio, accumulating to around 1.15% of Reliance Jio. The third acquisition was Vista Equity Partners, investing around 11,367 crores, coming to around 2.32%. The fourth, okay. Now, if you accumulate all these three, total investment by all these three companies comes to around 60,000 crores, 60,596 crores. And Facebook, it occurred in the date April 22nd, 2020. Facebook valued the entire Jio company at 4,35,000 crores. Guys, can you imagine 4,35,000 crores, 25% of the economic package declared by our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now, you'll be shocked to know that when investing, Reliance Jio invested around 2.5 lakh crore to start this business of Jio. At that point of time, it was almost three times of investment what all the rest of the telecom companies put together in the last 20 years did not make. That is three times of the investment of all the other telecommunication companies put together. Reliance had made a huge investment of 2.5 lakh crores. Everyone suspected, but today the numbers are speaking, that is, actions are speaking louder than words, right? So 4.35 lakh crore rupees was the valuation made by Facebook. Once Facebook entered into Jio has entered, or say it went in the cloud nine, because each and every company throughout the world now started planning to invest in Jio. And can you see here in the screen, Vista, which was the second investment made into Reliance Jio, valued Jio into 4,90,000 crores. Facebook valued it for 4,35,000 crores, and Vista valued it for 4,90,000 crores. Can you imagine just because Facebook has entered into Jio, the valuation of Jio raised up by 60,000 crore rupees. Just in a matter of 10 days, from 22nd April to 3rd May. 3rd May is the date when Vista invested into Reliance Jio. And when it came to 8th May, that is 4 days later, Silver Lake valued Jio at 4,91,000 crores. So can you all just get a grasp of it that once the big players are coming into your company's valuation automatically raises. Right? So now after that, the fourth, you know, investment made by KKR, which is also one of the US-based private equity investor, invested 11,367 crores, accumulating to around 2.32% of the Reliance Jio shareholding. The fifth acquisition, which was the last, but not the least, guys, the last, 6,598 crores, accumulating to 1.34% of the shareholding. The total investment in Reliance Jio right now is around 78,562 crores. Basically, the motto behind selling off Jio was to completely pay off the debt, which was around 1,60,000 crores. So out of that 1,60,000 crores, if you take almost 50% of the debt can be paid by Reliance Industries Limited today. Guys, Reliance Industries Limited right now has three major divisions. One is your petroleum, which is somewhere around 40% of the total Reliance Industries Limited. The next one is Reliance Digital, that is the retail segment. And the third big segment is Jio. Yeah, okay. If you see, the entire market cap right now of Reliance Industries Limited is 9.8 lakh crore. And out of that 9.8 lakh crore, Jio accumulates 50% of the market cap. Now, what is market cap? Basically, number of shares of that company multiplied by market price per share. For example, Reliance Industries Limited market price right now is around 1450, if I am not wrong. That is on the Friday's closing day. But then 1450 multiplied by the number of shares will give you the total market cap of Reliance Industries Limited. Right now, you cannot buy the share of Reliance Jio because it is not a listed company, right? So if you want to be a part of Reliance Jio, you had to only invest in Reliance Industries Limited. But once the IPO of Jio is coming up, yeah, I feel the Reliance Industries Limited valuation will come down drastically because the major segment there is petroleum, which doesn't have a bright future. So once Jio's IPO is coming, everyone will run behind Jio because there is a lot of scope even in the future for any telecommunication company or the technological company for that case. Now in March 2020, basically this is not March 2020, this is May 2020. So in March 2020, Reliance Industries Limited owned 100% in Jio. Right now, after all the sell-off of the shareholding, now it has come down to 82.88%. Right? So the rest around 17.12% has been sold off to five big private equity investors. The major one being Facebook. Right? So Facebook has got a lot of plans to expand in India. Basically, if you now see the figures of Reliance Jio, in 2019 it reported a profit of 2,964 crores. And in 2020, it raised up by 80%. 5,562 crore rupees. 80% growth in a telecom business is not a single day joke. Airtel, now if you compare with Airtel, which has been the most affected telecom companies in India, leave Vodafone Idea, which is already in the verge of bankruptcy, but since lockdown, even Vodafone Idea has been improving. Now let us see what is going to happen between these three giant companies in the telecom sector. And Airtel, 2009, it had a profit of 7,859 crores. Yeah, far higher than what Jio is even having today. But in 2019, its profit declined to 410 crores. Okay. Now, Reliance Jio is now going to enter into the e-commerce sector. Has already launched JioMart. In fact, I would tell the best time to launch JioMart company as such. Now this JioMart is going to compete straight away with Amazon and Flipkart, and I'm sure it's going to give a tough competition to these both e-commerce giants which are running throughout the world. Apart from e-commerce, it is now also planning to enter into the video conference, that is a web conferencing app called JioMeet. So Reliance Jio, I would say, has done, or in fact has made use of this lockdown in the best way possible, because so many changes kept the share price of Reliance Jio at par. That is, 1600 was the highest price reached by the Reliance Industries Limited. Also considering the rights issue made by Reliance Industries Limited in between, which was for accounting for around 50,000 crores and odd, the highest rights issue ever in the history of Indian stock market. Somewhere around 53,000 crores, if I am not wrong. Now, what is rights issue? Basically, every existing shareholder can buy one share at a price of 1,257 only. Existing shareholder can only buy. Right now the price is 1450, so can I tell a discount of around 10-15%? So that is a small knowledge about rights issue. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed this video a lot. A lot of information has been shared. Keep motivating me so that I'll keep on uploading such kind of videos. I hope you all are enjoying your vacations, right? So thank you guys, this was all about my presentation.